Jimmy Butler averaged just 2.6 points per game in his rookie season and is now a five-time NBA All-Star and one of the most respected players in the league. He's a hard worker who had to overcome extreme difficulties in life, and that's what's made him one of the most unique and interesting NBA personalities. Here are 10 things you didn't know about Jimmy Butler. His father abandoned him, and his mom kicked him out of the house at 13. The Jimmy Butler story is hard to explain just with basketball. His life story is impossible to ignore because it formed Jimmy both as a person and a basketball player. Rags-to-riches stories are not uncommon for NBA stars, but even the harshest environments and tough life conditions are not as grueling as what Jimmy Butler went through. His father abandoned him when he was just an infant, and Jimmy grew up in a small town not far from Houston with a single mother. When he was 13, she kicked him out of the house for a totally bizarre and inexplicable reason. "I don't like the look of you. You have to go," she said. And all of a sudden, Jimmy was homeless, alone, and without a dime in his pockets. However, Jimmy Butler proved that no matter how hard and cruel life can be, all you can do is persevere, push forward, and never give up. Couch surfed before a friend's family took him in. Jimmy Butler always said that he doesn't want anybody to feel pity for him, and that his circumstances made him into the man he is today, and that he's grateful for them. Besides, although he was technically homeless, he would usually find a place to stay, and he'd move around from one friend to another, and would stay as long as their parents would let him. The life of uncertainty and constant moving certainly wasn't easy, and the only thing he could always rely on was basketball, which would change his life, but not in the way it usually happens. It wasn't a talented kid in the project spotted by a basketball coach type of scenario. It was actually a kid younger than him that approached him after a game and challenged him to a three-point shooting contest. Jimmy accepted, and the two started hanging out and became friends. Kid's name was Jordan Leslie, and when he found out about Jimmy's life situation, he invited him to stay for the night at his house. At first, Leslie's mom, Michelle Lambert, was reluctant to let Jimmy stay because she had four kids of her own with her first husband, plus three others from her second marriage, and they weren't too happy to have another mouth to feed. However, all the children liked Jimmy, and soon he came over again and stayed a bit longer. After a while, they accepted him as their own, and Jimmy finally had a home and a family, which provided much-needed structure and stability in his life. After receiving no D1 offers, he attended a JUCO. Since he always had bigger things to worry about, Jimmy didn't give his basketball future much thought. He was just playing for fun, and he was far from the best player on the court. He never played AAU basketball, and how late Butler emerged as a promising player is perhaps best illustrated by his final year in high school. When he was ranked 73rd best player, not in the entire country, he was just 73rd in Texas. The university offers passed him by, and one of the few that arrived at his address came from Tyler Junior College, a two-year community college. It was better than nothing, but playing JUCO usually means falling even deeper into basketball anonymity. However, Jimmy Butler does not classify under usually or normally. Once he got the opportunity to train, without thinking about his next meal or a place to stay, he finally started to show glimpses of a future star. After several 40-point games for Tyler, he received scholarship offers from several prominent universities, including Marquette, Kentucky, Clemson, and Mississippi State. In the end, he opted for Marquette because of academic reasons, as he still only viewed basketball as a way to get an education and a regular job. He faxed his national letter of intent to Marquette from McDonald's. Do you remember we said that Jimmy Butler doesn't do things normally? Well, accepting a college scholarship is just another example of that. Jimmy never made an official visit to Marquette University. He faxed his letter of intent from a McDonald's in Tomball, Texas, where he grew up and where he was living with Michelle Lambert and his new family. His first visit to Marquette was on the first day of classes, and that's where he'd meet a man who would change his reality once again, Coach Buzz Williams. He led Marquette to three straight March Madness appearances. Butler's first season at Marquette was a roller coaster, and he'd often fight with Coach Williams, who was extremely tough on him. "I've never been harder on a player than I've been on Jimmy. I was ruthless on him because he didn't know how good he could be. He'd been told his whole life that he wasn't good enough. What I was seeing was a guy who could impact our team in so many ways," Buzz Williams. By Butler's own admission, he didn't have the work ethic at the beginning of his college career because he didn't see the bigger picture and couldn't even grasp that a basketball career might be possible. But that would change with the influence of Coach Williams and teammate Wes Matthews, who told him that he had what it takes to make it to the NBA. Matthews had just started his NBA career, and that's when Jimmy's perspectives started to change. Soon, he became the hardest worker Coach Williams had ever seen, and he blossomed from a role player to a star of the team. As a senior in 2010 and 11, he averaged 15.7 points per game after which he declared for the NBA draft, where he was selected 29th overall by the Chicago Bulls. He is a huge fan of country music. When you see an NBA player walking into the arena with headphones, you'd probably guess they're listening to hip-hop. In most cases, that would be correct, but not for Jimmy Butler. Jimmy likes country music to the dismay of his teammates, who often say that they can't stand his music choice. Well, Jimmy is from Texas, which would explain the country, but he also really digs Taylor Swift, which is even more surprising. Close friends with Mark Wahlberg. Mark Wahlberg was filming Transformers: Age of Extinction in Chicago in 2013 when he and his crew got an unexpected invitation from the Bulls to play pickup basketball at the Birdo Center, the Bulls' famous practice facility. A big basketball fan, Wahlberg accepted and went on to play pickup with a few friends from the movie set, and Butler stayed after practice to play with them. Wahlberg then invited Butler to join them for dinner, and the two stars struck an unlikely friendship. Now, they vacation together, and Jimmy has a great relationship with Wahlberg's children. Wahlberg is not the only celebrity bromance of Jimmy's. During the 2016 Olympics, where Butler won gold with Team USA, he got really interested in soccer and became a huge fan of Neymar, who won a gold medal with the Brazilian soccer team. The two became friends, and through Neymar, he also met other soccer stars, like Kylian Mbappe and Paul Pogba. He is now a father. Jimmy signed a maximum deal with the Miami Heat this past offseason, which will net him $142 million over 4 years. And even though he was healthy and anxious to play with his new team, he missed the first two games of the season for personal reasons. Jimmy's girlfriend, Caitlin Nowak, gave birth to a baby girl named Riley, and Jimmy admitted that his perspective of life changed immediately for the better. He cussed out a GM during practice. Until this season, Jimmy had a reputation of a problematic guy who was a pain in the butt for his coaches, teammates, and the front office. With all the previous teams, Chicago, Minnesota, and Philadelphia, the relationship went sour at the end. However, the legendary Pat Riley, president of the Heat for the past 25 years, never liked anybody so fast as he liked Jimmy, not even Dwayne Wade. "They brought me to be who I am," Butler explained, with his biggest crime being that he always says what he thinks, and many couldn't stand it. "He came to Miami because such a character trait is seen as a virtue, not as a flaw, and because they are known for not tolerating a lack of work ethic," which is an opinion shared by Butler. When he was in Minnesota, Butler clashed with Karl-Anthony Towns and Andrew Wiggins for their lackadaisical approach to basketball, and he wanted to be traded. After his request was denied, Jimmy cussed out GM Scott Layden until he was finally traded to Philadelphia. Jimmy is punishing Bam Adebayo for not taking threes and charges coffee for Heat players. Despite a maximum deal he signed, Jimmy also likes to earn some money on the side, at teammates' expense. His teammates in Miami adore him, and he became a mentor for many of their young stars, namely Bam Adebayo, who blossomed into an all-star this year. Because Bam was not comfortable shooting threes in the game, Jimmy decided to motivate him with money. For each game in which he does not attempt a three-pointer, Adebayo is obliged to give Butler $500. To be fair, the same rule applied to Butler as well. I'm not sure if they followed up on that bet, but I know that Jimmy raked quite a bit of money if they did, because Bam attempted just 14 threes for the season. Aside from that, Jimmy also started a business venture in the Orlando bubble. He started selling coffee from his own coffee machine to teammates and anyone interested, for $20 a cup. A really unique individual is that Jimmy.